The body-mind connection is something that has fascinated many since mankind first started practicing medicine. Today, medical science is just beginning to understand all of the ways in which the mind influences our bodies. Strange observations like the placebo effect demonstrate that people can, from time to time, create relief from medical symptoms by only the belief in a cure working. This process is poorly understood. The body's ability to heal itself is far more miraculous than modern medicine could create. So while there are many unexplained phenomena, the unexplainable science of the body and the mind connection, even as science makes advances trying to figure it out, may be among the most amazing phenomena of all. What could this mean for future medicine, and what could we do to strengthen this connection? Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history and mystery. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss a video again. For centuries, medicine men and healers have pondered the connection between mental and physical health. In recent years, science has begun to realize the potential in this powerful connection, observing how emotional, spiritual, and behavioral factors can directly affect health outcomes. Research in the field of mind-body medicine is quickly discovering that emotions and thought patterns contribute to imbalances within the body, and certain alternative therapies such as hypnosis, visual imagery, meditation, yoga, and biofeedback can be used to re-establish a balance in the connection and promote good health and healing. The field of psychoneuroimmunology has witnessed an explosion in its findings over the last two decades. This research has documented many mechanisms through which stressful emotions can alter the function of white blood cells. Stress diminishes the white blood cells' ability to respond to viral infections and even cancers. It was found that vaccinations are less effective in those who are feeling stressed, and wounds heal less quickly. When stress is decreased in the activity of white blood cells, there is an enhancing of the body's ability to combat disease. In his book, The Biological Mind, Alan Jasanoff, professor of biological engineering at MIT, explains why this cerebral mystique creates a false dichotomy between the brain and the body and ignores bodily influences on our psychology, from chemicals in the blood to the bacteria in the gut. The professor writes about the two opposing ideas. First, the biological mind centered on the brain, in which influences from the rest of the body and outside the body shape what we think and do. Secondly, the cerebral mystique, a complex of stereotypes and ideals about the brain, which tend to treat it as an isolated and all-powerful entity, almost like a modern version of the soul. He gives the example of how neurological pathways connect parts of the brain that process emotions with the spinal cord, muscles, cardiovascular system, and digestive tract. This connection allows the major events in our lives, the stresses or emotions, to trigger actual physical symptoms. He explains how many people have experienced this mind-body connection when the feeling of butterflies in your stomach comes when you are nervous, or when under intense stress, your heart feels like it's pounding out of your chest. This new area of neuroscience is known as connectomics, and it seeks to give a unifying theory of the brain and its body connection. Connectomics is seen as two different things. One, mapping the individual structures, chiefly cells in the brain. The other, looking at the superhighways that connect different regions of the brain and tries to relate those to aspects of brain activity and genetics. Both of these views are trying to describe key aspects of brain function in terms of its intrinsic structure. There is the possibility that if researchers knew where every cell connected, they could simulate how a brain works and, in the most extreme form, model an entire life in a computer. This could lead to a huge advancement in AI and artificial brains, along with the field of transhumanism. Transhumanism has its sights focused on the brain. The field of research is about creating people who somehow go beyond the conceived ideas of the normal As an example, the Internet of the Mind is the idea of linking people's minds directly to the Internet using brain implants, this creating mind-to-mind communication without the need for speech or typing. This idea takes us into the realms of science fiction for the moment. Pick your movie, The Matrix, RoboCop, and the many others that ask the question, are we our body or mind? Could this be a dark and dangerous thing to do? The futuristic direction, which is promoted by transhumanism, is to some extent fueled by the mystique of the brain-body connection. Can a mind exist without a body? Does consciousness need a physical manifestation? Consciousness is a physical manifestation. The one we experience with a human brain is perfectly superimposable to a complex psychological and neurological activity of which minute variations transform the state of consciousness. A good example would be the circadian biochemical changes and the slowing of the activity of certain neurons which makes you fall asleep. Sleep is a modified state of consciousness. When sleeping, we are considerably less connected. We are in a state altered from waking consciousness, but we are still living. The body takes over. In this process that is so familiar to us, we barely give it any thought. If consciousness arises from the partnership of body and mind, without the body, the mind does not exist. And without both, consciousness would not exist. At least for the moment, the brain-body connection cannot be broken or replicated. This, I feel, is a good thing. We should heed the warnings of science fiction. Do you think the mind has untapped potential for manipulating our bodies? Do you think it can exist outside of a body? If it could, should we separate our biological bodies from our minds? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you like what we do here on the channel, hit that subscribe button, like and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.
In the beginning, man created machines to lead their society. For the world was without form and order, darkness was upon the face of the earth. This is the story of our genesis.